All right, what's good, y'all? It's your boy Bobby W223 here, and this is my review for X-Men Days of Future Past. Now, I went and saw this movie Thursday night premiere or whatever you want to call it. Went to see it for my birthday. The movie was absolutely amazing. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not the best movie of all time, nothing like that, but this is a great movie. I'm gonna try to stay, realistic and not be too over zealous or overhyped, but this was a great movie from start to finish, from top to bottom. Great action, great story, great characters and the acting, everything. Now, I know a lot of people have said in their reviews that Quicksilver was the highlight for them for the movie. And don't get me wrong, Quickstar was awesome. He was funny. I like the way that they showed off his powers in the movie. But for me, the standout character in this movie, just like in First Class, Magneto. Magneto was the standout guy for me in First Class, and once again, he stole the show to me. The last scene in the movie, and he, I'll put spoilers in the title, but he's tearing up the Sentinels and controlling them all, and he's having them all fly around and shit, and he kind of just takes everything into his own hands, because Magneto always has his own agenda. You can never fully trust Magneto, and that's the cool thing about him, is that him and Professor X are two sides of the same coin. It's really Martin Luther King and Malcolm X. That's pretty much what it is. Overall, it was great, and really there wasn't too much in this movie that I can nitpick. Now, I know there's gonna be some people out there who maybe possibly haven't seen the movie yet, or when they go to see it, or the people that have seen it that are the diehard comic book fans of this story, or even from the 90s cartoon days. And don't get me wrong, I love the cartoons. I've read some of the comic books, and I can understand these concerns I'm going to bring up, but really, it's one of those things that overall, the movie was still great, and I kind of understand from a live-action standpoint, it made more sense for them to do certain things. And what I'm talking about is the fact that, they send Wolverine back in time instead of, I believe, Kitty Pryde is the one that goes back, or it's Bishop. I think it's Bishop in the cartoon. They have Bishop go back, but then in the comic books, it's Kitty Pryde. But correct me if I'm wrong. But whichever way, in the movie, obviously Wolverine is the one that goes back in time. And I know some people are probably gonna nitpick that, like, oh, that's not accurate to the story, and blah blah blah. Like, you gotta just look at this as its own thing, and its own canon, and I think it makes more sense from, once again, from a live action, movie standpoint, to have Wolverine go back. And speaking of Bishop, once again, people that are diehard fans, Bishop really wasn't as big, didn't have as big of a role in this movie as a lot of people may think, since, he's one of the main people in this, Days of Future Past story arc. Like, he is in the movie, but most of this film takes place in the past, in the 70s, and they have some of the bigger action scenes, or when they go back to the future and show what's going on there. Otherwise, all the other action scenes are set in the past, but they kind of jump back and forth and things like that from the past in the future. But the main focal point of the movie is set in the past, and then they show parts of what's going on in the future and things like that as well. People die, obviously. If you know the story, pretty much kind of know the gist of it. And Trask, the guy who creates the Sentinels, he's great. All the characters are great. They don't really show a lot of the characters from First Class that are in the movie. They kind of hint that some of the people are either dead or already captured that they didn't show, but they do show Havoc, but he's only in maybe like one or two scenes, things like that. But overall, it's pretty much, Mystique, Magneto, Professor X, and Wolverine. I think those are pretty much like the main four, and then you got Quicksilver, and then in the future timeline, you have future Professor X and Magneto and Storm and Blink and Iceman, who was awesome, and Sunspot, and everybody else. Except Bishop was cool and everything like that, but they didn't really show them as much as even I would like to. But I understand, they had to have a focus on this movie. Once again, this is a live action movie. They gotta make it focused, and I understand that. But overall, great movie. Love the dynamic between Magneto and Professor X. Once again, those guys gotta butt heads. I liked how, which in one of the trailers, they talked about this, about how Professor X took a serum that Beast made to give him the ability to walk, but unfortunately, he pretty much had to sacrifice his powers because of the serum affects his DNA to a point where he can't use his powers. And once again, they show that in one of the clips where they're in the airplane scene. And Beast also takes the same serum as Professor X. Once again, he's the one that made it, but he doesn't take as much as what Professor X does, so he can still use his powers, but he's kind of like the Incredible Hulk, I guess. Like, once he kind of loses control, then he transforms into Beast. Whereas Professor X, he takes so much of it that he just can't use his powers. But then eventually, Wolverine kind of talks him into coming back and using Cerebros, and then he, sacrifices his ability to walk to pretty much become Professor X, and kind of rally everybody together and whatnot. But yeah, overall, top to bottom, great action once again. I loved it. This is one of the best X-Men movies. It's right up there with X-Men 2 and First Class, which are my opinion. Those are the best ones. This is right on par with those movies. I loved it. I love the clip at the end, the end credit scene with Apocalypse, and he's using his powers to form the pyramids and things like that. So, they're hinting at the next X-Men movie coming out in 2016. So that's gonna be great. Enjoyed it. I give it a 9.5 out of 10. I wish they would have, shown a little more scenes in the future, because those action scenes were badass. But from what the action scenes that they did show were great. I just wish there was more of them. But yeah, 9.5 out of 10. Go check out the site. Link will be in the description below. And this is your boy, Bobby W223, and peace out.